Welcomes all the participants for today's National Distance Learning Seminar Series. Today's topic is 99 dots for TB treatment adherence monitoring, overview, best practices and mobile application, and speaker is Ms. Reena Kutan. Ms. Reena has overall 14 years of experience in various roles and capacities. She had worked for more than 10 years in the development sector, including disability, and also as employability expert for people with multiple disabilities and autism. Currently, she is working as consultant 99 Dots Project and is managing the outreach program for different states. She has also been involved in developing different training materials. We also have with us Dr. Deepak Balasubramanyam, who is the National Consultant HIV-TB at NACO. He will be facilitating in answering all the questions at the end of the session. We welcome both of you for today's NDLS session. I would request Ms. Reena to kindly take over the session now.
Thank you, Divya. Good afternoon, all. So welcome to the distance learning sessions. Okay. So I think already all of most of you know and have done some work on the 99 dots, but quickly I just wanted to go through what is 99 dots and how it is useful for the patient. Those are the things and all. So already you guys know how to the testing part will happen when the patient comes to the ART center. After that, how they are positively diagnosed with the TB things, then later on giving the 99 dots dosages, and you will be explaining how to use the ART in the ART center, how you will be using the 99 envelopes, and how the patient information will be in the ART center. So for the more detailed thing, even you can, we have shared the video link. You can go through the video link and you can see the videos on that particular thing. So just as a recap, because most of the ART center already launched the 99 dots, quickly once again, whoever the new ART centers are there, to show them. So this is how usually our 99 dots envelopes. It's a simple solution where the patient can take the medicine. After taking the medicine every day, they will be getting the one unpredictable number, and they will be calling to the that unpredictable toll-free number. So that time the the system will record the patient information, whether the patient has taken the pill or not. So this is the small demo you can see on the slides. So this is a two pills ka thing where the patient should follow the arrow mark. So once the patient take the medicine, then how we can get the access to the data? Here we can see, I'm sorry, once again, yeah. So here we can see, for an example, okay. So here you can see the patient name, and also how many patients are in green color, in red color and pink color, different colors are there. So what it means in the end, during the demo, I will be explaining more on that particular part. So each time, so when patient is registered with 99 dots, so if the patient is not taking the pill, the same day they will get the reminder at 1 o'clock. So still the patient, if not giving the free call to the 99 dots, then the alerts will go, after 2 hours, the alerts will go to the particular staff, the field staff, and they will be checking the information. Here you can see the SMS 0040s. Here we can see it's based on the dosage, the pills, how many patients you take. For an example, if the patient is taking four pills, they will be getting 4 zeros. If the 3 pills, 3 zeros. So it will be like that. And also the alert SMS for the staff will go, how many patient missed the pills, and it will give the with the name and the phone number. This is the Raj and the phone number, and Om the phone number. And here they are the dashboard, you can see the green, red. And also the notification thing. So once the ART center register the patient, the RNTCP will get the immediate information that the patient, new patient, has registered ART center. So this is the feature of the ART 99 thing. Anyway, already you guys know, but quickly I'll just recap the thing. So this call is the free call, and patient can make the call from any place from the different places also, from the roaming also. There is no charges for this calls, and also they, after calling, they should keep hearing till they get the thank you message. And the more the details, we will be sending you the checklist how you need to explain about 99 dots and how you should give the counseling to the patient. So we, in the end, we will be sharing the counseling checklist also, or you can go to website and download the 99 dots. You can download the counseling checklist also. So as per our 13th March 2017, the patient, 16,414 patient are registered in ART centers. So you can see here the different things, the numbers and all here. And same way, this is the one quick information on how many centers are already launched and not launched, yet to launch. So I think more than for 98 centers yet to launch the ART, 99 dots. So due to some different reason, genuine reason, they were not able to do the things. So I hope after this training, they will be able to launch this program. The one more very, very important thing for the ART people. So when they are doing the case, so the counseling part, why it is so important. We have done one small research in Bangalore, one of the hospitals. So we went with all our envelopes and randomly we asked the patient to, we gave the envelopes and we asked them to remove the pills. So, but no one has followed the arrow mark which we have given. So in the back side, you can see the arrow mark where the patient has to follow the arrow mark and they need to call. So without any instruction, we have given the information, we have given the pill, but it was a failure thing. So that's why anytime any person when comes to the ART center, the counseling part is very, very important. So how to take the pill, how many medication they need to do and how to make the calls, we should explain to the person. Then only the patients will be calling on daily basis. So on the counseling checklist, we will be sharing the checklist with you. So this is a kind of a small print screen I have shared with you guys to just understand how the things will look. So what are the information we need to share with the patient. So what are the benefits of 99 dots? Because the patient, when the patient is coming and we are giving the medicine, and after taking medicine, patient is giving the call. So it's either because of that, the patient no need to travel for the long time. Only 28 days once the patient should come and take the medicine. So less travel, and because of less travel, the convenience of the patient is more. And same way for the field staff and the supervisor, they no need to follow up with all the patient. They need to follow only the patient who are missed the doses. Based on the dashboard, they can understand how many patients are not taking the medicine, and only they will be following up what is the reason, what happened, and they will be focusing more on the non-doses patient, and because of that their efficient will be more. And for the program officers, it's very easy for them to monitor the patient, and also they will be getting the accurate reports for their review meetings. So this is how our envelopes looks. For an example, 2 pills, 3 pills, 4 pills and 5 pills, different colors you will be getting. So based on that, patient will be using for the calling. So next important thing is how to register the patient in 99 dots. So here in the slide, quickly I will go. In the end, I will take some 5-10 minutes and I will show the demo. So whenever you log in into 99 dots, you can see here the 99, the add patient. Here you can see the red circle one. So when you click there, you will get the first name patient, first name, surname, adherence, and these are the information. Their primary number, secondary number, you need to fill the information. The most important thing is here, we need to collect multiple numbers from the patient, because if the patient is disconnected with the number, we can trace the patient with the other numbers also. And also the state and district when we are entering, you should be very careful. Sometimes the other district patient may come to different district and take the medication, that time you need to change the district. So this is the same thing, primary numbers, so take the multiple numbers with the patients, and here you can take the district and TU on step 3. Step 4 will be the Nikshay ID, TB number and TB category. If you don't have, you can skip this area, and when the RNTCP will go and get the information, they will edit and they will put this information on that. So in the demo, I will show you all in detail. The one more very, very important thing, when we are collecting data from the patient, we need to be really very careful, because most of the time we heard from different RNTCP people, because when the patient comes and register, they register with the permanent number. But most of the time the patient, the current address will be a different address. If the patient is not following the medicine, then it is difficult for them to follow the thing. So whenever the patient comes to ART center, you need to do a double check with the person where the person currently staying, and take the proper address with the landmark and update in the thing. So because of this, it will be easy for the RNTCP people to do the follow up or home visit. And the one more, this is the major thing which we need to take. And sometime it's better always to take one or two numbers. Many cases like this. For an example, one DPS person called 99.steam and they asked, "Madam, the person is calling every day and the person is hearing thank you message also, but in the dashboard we are seeing the red color. So what is the reason?" Then we asked all the information, the patient information, and we went and we checked. Then we saw when they did the data entry, that time they have missed one number. So most of the time when the patient is giving the number and entering the data, if it goes wrong, that time it is very difficult, it will not get the green color, so it will be red only. So when we changed the number again, it automatically came into green color. So whenever the person, data entry person, is entering the data, should be more careful and do the double check on the data. So after entering data, in case if we do any mistakes or if you wanted to change any patient information, you can go to that particular patient. And also here on the right side, you can see edit details in blue color button. You need to click there and you can edit the patient information. So during the demo, I will show how you can edit and change the patient information. And also same way, you need to enter all the medical information about the patient. So whatever the different information they will be having. So this also I'll show in the demo part, how all the information you can edit about the patient details. And if the patient medication is over, or in between the patient needs to drop out due to some different reason, even we have a close case option, so where you can close the patient information there. And also after closing, if you wanted to reopen the patient also, even you can get that information. And one more very important thing, if you wanted to see the reports part, you can just go to on my left side, you can see the reports here, reports which is circled in blue red color. So you can go there and download. Based on that, you will be, if you wanted the summary report, you will be getting the summary report. If you wanted the detailed report, even you will be getting the detailed report also. So we have, based on our experience, we have captured few best practices also. For an example, why it is so important to get the correct details of the patient, correct number, because one example already I have shared, because of the wrong numbers, most of the time we are not able to capture the whether patient has taken the medication or not. And also anytime when patient comes to the center, please take the multiple numbers. If the any friends or family members are coming, you can take the number and you can update. So at a time you can update four different numbers. and also you need to collect the landmark also, because the when RNTC people are going for the house visit, it is easy for them to do the things. And also you need to ensure regarding 99 dots, how to use the envelopes and how they need to make a call. And also So whenever if the patient is getting their phone number to the center, after for the first dosage, you can ask the patient to take in ART center itself. So after taking the medicine, the person can give the call and hear the thank you message. So they will understand this is how I need to do. And whenever patient come to the center to the refill after 28 days, so you can get some information about the patient. If you have any information which you wanted to communicate to RNTC people, you can use the tags and notes where you can enter all the information, and this will be the communication between ART and RNTC people. So most of the time the follow-ups, everything RNTC people only will be doing, but the when the patient comes, the first contact is from the ART, the counselor, because they will be telling what are the things to do, the counseling part, or what are the different things, any problem, because they have seen you all physically, so you are the best person to explain more and more to the patient. So the more information, whatever the PPTs or slides, here you can see the 99 dots videos and all. So you can download and you can go through the same whatever I have explained. You have the videos also, and also the checklist, different checklist. Counseling checklist also you can download from here. And the one more thing, we are going to launch the mobile app also. So when you go and do a Google Store download 99 app, so then you will be getting like this. Then you need to install your app, and from your ART username and password you can click and sign in. So you need to use your same Nikshay user ID and password only, same as. So then you can see, you will be seeing this first screen. So how to you the current patient, past patient and add patient, and these are the different features you can use. So you can add the patient here whenever the patient comes to here, and if you wanted to go and see the current patient how they are doing, you can click here and you can see the different things. And also you can use the sort button based on that patient ID or last dosage or priority wise enrollment date, so you can get the information like this. So you can add the patient and patient basic details and all you can add here. The patient details, the name, first name, all their basic information you need to add here. Yeah. And the treatment start date also, and choose the date, tentative date, those things and also you can do. And the other one, this where I'm moving my cursor. So you can see the patient details. This is more for RNTCP people, because they can do a after visiting home, they can see what are the if the patient is taken the medication due to some reason not able to give a call, they can go and mark manual doses here. Yeah. Also you can view the current patient history. So in the down, for an example here, if you push up, you can see the summary of the patient, today's adherence, how much and for how many patient required the attention. These are the information you will be able to see. And this is more for the counseling part also. You can, whenever the patient comes, you can go and you can show, hey, see, so many days you did not call the thing, and on 3rd, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th you have called, what is the thing. You can use this app for the counseling purpose also. So you can see the patient notes, you can add the patient notes also here. So this is what about the thing. Now I will get into demo. And I will in 5 minutes, we will 5-10 minutes, we will finish the demo and we will take all your questions later on. Okay, so we have taken one of the ART centers, so you need to log into www 99 dots.org and you need to use your Nikshay ID and password and you can log into the system. So then the first thing will come overview. So in the overview you can see, for an example, we have taken the Bikashi ART center, and you can see the how many patient are in medium and how many patient are in higher tension, and how many percentage of people have called already today. For an example, you can see your taken pills today 22%. So still 78% people are yet to take the medication. And for you, anytime when the patient comes to ART center, the first thing you need to do is add patient. So you need to click on add patient. So whatever I have shown on the slides, you can see here. For an example, I just do a test. You can do. So, and also you need to enter. So I was saying the primary number, and also you can take some other. So always better to take multiple numbers. So these are the information you can take here. Numbers, and also you need to enter ART and pre-ART numbers. Then you need to be very careful when we are choosing this state and district thing. And also the other basic information. So this and all, we need to do the things. Then we need to add patient. So then the patient will be added here. So here I'm not going to add because this is a live ART center. So once that is done, current patient, let me go to current patient. So here you can see, for an example, I'm just clicking with one patient. So here you can see the details. If you wanted to see the details of the patient, it's here. So in case if the patient phone number is changed, you can come here and edit details, and you can change the phone number or other information of the patient. So, and one more major part which you need to take care of is medical details. So it's a shared responsibility. Both RNTCP and ART people should enter this data. So whatever the initial data you will be getting about the treatment, you need to enter here, and whichever is not able to get, and whichever is not able to get it, the RNTC people will be doing it. So if you wanted to change any information here, again you can come here, edit details, and you can do the editing of the thing. So you, here you can all the information about the your medical, the patient medical history, HIV status also you can add, RBS information and different things. So the tags and notes, this is what I was talking. So anytime when patient comes here, so you can come here and you can put alter tags and notes, and you can enter the information whatever you wanted on this particular thing. And also here the close case. So if the patient, if you wanted to close, the treatment is over, or due to some reason the patient is not on 99 dots or anything, you can close the case. So always we should not use the delete patient, because if you are going to delete the patient, you cannot recover the data. So only in one situation you can delete the delete patient, if the patient is in duplicate thing. So you need to verify which is the original, the data you are having, and delete the other one. And also here you can see the report. So you can come, you can see the district wise summary report, and also if you wanted detailed reports also is available here. So demographic wise, medical wise, and adherence wise also. So these are the major thing which for the ART center people. I think now we are getting more and more questions. Let us go through the question and we will get back to you on this now. Any questions on this? I'm just looking into the question, ART center. Okay, so I'm reading one question. Madam, in our center, one client taking 99 dots, they are taking tablets every day. But when they call, when they get error, check the number. Okay, check the number, what will do? Okay, so first, however, we told this is major, in major places we are hearing this complaint. So two, three things we need to do. One is we need to see whether the patient has called with the registered number only. If the patient is calling with the other number, it is not possible. Sometimes it can be a network issues also. Sometimes what the patient will do, they will add 0 or 91. We should not do that also. So we need to inquire this thing, and also whenever the patient is telling like that, please collect their ID number, their from which number they called, that patient phone number, register phone number, and also the toll free number. So then you can share with us and we will see what is the real problem will be there. But you need to do a basic check whether the patient has called with the registered number, and make sure they are not added 0 or 91. Those are the things. If edit the phone number, not taking is coming as invalid. Invalid number. No, I think if you have gone to the edit button, so as I showed here, and after updating the things, you need to update phone number. Otherwise, 1 minute, let me see. I'm showing you the thing, the pay, whoever have asked here. So edit details, come back here, and you need to delete this number and enter new number, and in the end you need to submit changes, then it will come. If any problem, I don't think so, it will be there. Then you need to check with your internet speed also, because yesterday only we saw one in one of the place, the internet was very slow and they were entering very fast. Due to that also can happen. So the next one, okay, this one, okay, need option to enter CBNet details. Okay, I think I have covered already this. You can, under medical details, you can go and check the information. Okay, the next person have asked, for two pills a day, the hidden number is not is on the second one, but in the three pills a day, it is in the first pill. In this situation, the patient takes only one pill and leaves the other. Need to modify it. Okay. So I think I will get back to you on this. I was not able to understand this question. Let me read once again and I will reply for sure. I will reply for this question. Okay. The next person has asked, can we send missed call from land phone? Yes, it's not a missed call, because that's how usually we most of the time we are telling to our patient, it's a free call. You should, missed call means they will call and immediately they will cut. You can register the land number also, but they need to call that number and they should hear thank you message. Till that time they need to wait. So you can register landline number also. The next person, ma'am, we are not able to edit the phone number. So I think now your doubt has got cleared. Because here there is a edit button and you can go and do the things. Okay, the next person is asking if the PT having jaundice. Okay, patient is having jaundice after starting attend, then we continue treatment. I think this you need to check with your medical officers, because I'm not the medical wise, I'm not an expert thing. So this you need to check with your medical officers. And the next person is asked, which effect should be given to patient when 99 started, is on first line, later on started second line, ARV treatment. Patient will be shifted to rifampin. Which effect should be marked in end case? Actually, I was not able to understand this question. Anyway, if it is possible, I will get back to you on this particular thing. So your question is taken, for sure I will reply you. So the next one is, how to generate Nikshay ID. So this is about the Nikshay. No idea. If RNTCP, they will take care of the things. So Nikshay ID things and all, they will see the thing. Yeah. The next question is, need the communication message in local language to the patient. Okay, this is a very good question. So even we are thinking on this. Maybe this is as a feedback also we have taken. We will get back to you on this. I will go and we will discuss with internally also, and I will get back to you on this. As of now, I don't have answer for this question. But it's a good suggestion which even we wanted to implement on that. So the next, ART, okay. If one mobile number for couple okay, two people, then what should be done, or any problem in patient adherence. Okay, so for an example, in most of the time where we can register two people with one single number, that time it automatically comes in yellow color. So you can do that, and any problem in patient adherence, RNTCP will take care. So during they will call or they will visit, and they will understand what is the problem, what has happened. If they say no, I'm taking the medicine because of some reason I was not able to give a call, so that time they can come back here and they can mark doses manually also. So that green color, dark green color will turn into green color, light green. So that possibilities are there. So next, if patient live on footpath and they have no mobile numbers, so what to do? So this I have no answer for this. I think you guys should think on this, what you wanted to do on this particular thing. So the next patient, ma'am, once we enter the number, after few days, if the patient say the have changed the number, okay, so you can go to edit details, and you can edit the patient details and the phone numbers also. Okay, if does not have phone number facility, what to do? Okay, already we have addressed that. The next question is, some patients are complaining. Okay, maybe complaining regarding the 99 dots contact numbers are not connecting properly and busy. What to do? Okay, so this we are hearing. So we need to check. In the earlier I have told, we need to check whether the patient is following all the methodology whatever we have told them. If still it is coming like that, you need to get the patient ID, the number, phone number, and please share with us, and we will see internally what to do. What should enter if patient shifted to treatment changed? Okay, so this I will get back to you. So I'm not able to understand. I will get back to you on this particular question. How will you deal confidentiality issues while sharing his condition? So in our counseling checklist, we have mentioned that we will tell the patient whatever the information they have shared with us, we are not going to tell anyone. So that is the confidentiality we are going to maintain. That's what usually we will tell to the people. What about the patient who does not have phone numbers? It's already addressed. So I think this, you guys need to come up with a best solution. Okay, the next question. If the person old age, orphan, if does not have mobile, what to do? Okay, this is addressed already. If the, okay, the next one, patient says that there is no ring when they call. Okay, so we need to follow, as earlier I told, whether they are following all the methods or not, then we can get back to on this particular thing. Okay, ma'am, we have also tried from DPT phone number to do toll free patient number. It was coming as invalid number. Okay, so please share the number with us and let us see whether it is a technical error or network issues. We can check on that. Okay, Nikshay ID number, who is giving? So that you need to check with RNTCP. I have no idea on this particular thing. Yeah. So the next, Sunday toll free not working. This is for the first time I'm hearing. Anyway, let us check on this, because toll free number works all 7 days. Any holidays, public holidays, all the holidays, it works. Okay. So the next question, is it possible to generate report in mobile app? Yes, you can view also and see the details and all on that particular thing. If the patient is not having mobile, then what to do? So already this shared with you what to do. How to share with you? Do you have any email ID? Yes, I have in the PPT, you can see, and also you can log into our website. The more information you will be getting there, how to contact us. Okay, so the next question, one patient by name, okay, I am not going to read the name, who is on 99 dots, he is taking a tablet correctly, he is calling also for the toll free number, but in the dashboard it is showing yellow color. Okay, yellow color means two patients are sharing same number. Yellow color means they are calling it. So that's not a worry. If it is a red color, then the patient is not taking medication or not calling. So yellow color means the patient is on adherence, no problem. So the next question, how to update death in 99 dots sites? So you can go to close case. In the close case, you can put the close case thing. And here you have in the treatment outcome, you have different thing, cure, treatment completed or failure, died, defaulted or transferred out. You can select any one of this and change the date also. Then you can submit the button. Okay, the next question, how can we change the phone number of the client? Already it's addressed. Okay, the next 99 dot is on iOS platform. Okay, oh, iPhone. Yes, you can check on that. The next question, okay, ma'am, in dashboard it is not taking edit option for new phone number. Okay, no, you should get it because as of now I have shown you. You try once again. If you are not able to do, please send us information. We will get back to you on that. Okay, please share your mobile number, email ID. Yes, in the end we are going to share that. How to update death? Already I have addressed the death information how to do. The next, madam, tell me detail of detailed of tax. Okay, already I think this information we have shared. So you can come here. And if the patient, whatever the information is there, you can come, alter tax, and you can put all the information. For an example, phone issues, if anything is there, or regarding any supply chain issues, you can add here, or any health issues about the patient, you can add here, and you can update the information. If any other extra notes you wanted to put, you can update and submit the button. Okay, the next question. How to change the mobile number? I have already addressed how to update. How to update? That is also addressed about the death. How to update death? Okay. People are asking more on how to close case. I have addressed those things and all. So now with me, I have Dr. Deepak. The few question, the technical question and all. I think he will be helping me to address the things and all. So thank you so much. I'm just handing over to Dr. Deepak.
Hello, good afternoon everyone. So we'll be taking some questions here. So one question is from madam, if you change the phone number, you're getting red color to the previous dates. So once we decide to change the phone number, the primary number should not be changed. So the previous number which has been registered should not be deleted. The additional number should be included in the secondary phone number. So next question is, you will add ART center list in 99 dots app for on patient transfer out. So if you are transferring out a patient to a different health facility, the patient, the treatment district of the patient would be changed. The ART center would not be changed, the district would be changed. So if no mobile facility is available, then what can be done? So if no mobile facility is available, there are other methods to ensure adherence, which includes providing treatment from a family provider or a health provider, which includes ASHA, Anganwadi worker or a ANM. Next question is, so need more info about transfer out. So transfer out in under RNTCP is in those cases wherein the patient is transferred from one district to another district. So when a patient is transferred to other district, the ART center would change the residence districts of the patient. So what is RBS? So RBS is random blood sugar. So how to generate Nikshay ID? So Nikshay ID is given by the RNTCP, wherein the STS or the data entry operator registers the patient in the Nikshay portal of RNTCP and generates the ID. So it is given by RNTCP. So what to do out of district patient? Patient is taking ART from our center, but he is from other district. Who will provide AKT? So when the patient is from the attending the ART center and taking the ART medication from the ART center, he will be provided AKT or ATT from the same ART center itself. So if we change the mobile number, we are getting red color to the previous dates. So as already mentioned, so we should not delete the phone number which has already been entered. We should keep the number as such, and we should add the additional numbers in the secondary phone number. If the person is old age, orphan, or if he does not have mobile, what to do, madam? So if the person doesn't have mobile number, then we can use other methods of treatment adherence, which would include a family provider giving the medication or a health worker, which includes ASHA, Anganwadi or ANM. So I think we have addressed most of the questions. So how will you deal with confidentiality issues while sharing this condition? So what we are doing under this is we are using shared confidentiality. So the details of the patient, which includes HIV status, are shared with the health providers, which includes the RNTCP team, so that they can take care of the patients. So how to update death in 99.dots portal. So this has already been addressed. We have to go to the close case and then select the treatment option and give the date and click the submit button. The patient takes your drug regularly, but he can't call on 99.dots. So what to do for it? So if suppose the patient is taking medication regularly and he can't call on the number, the RTCP staff, which includes STS, he would log into the web portal and he can mark manual doses for those patients. So how to handle discharged patients who is not having mobile number or address? So these would be handled by the RNTCP team, wherein a family member or a health worker would have to ensure adherence. Can 99.dots release Android version? So as already mentioned, Android version is available in the Google Play Store, where we can search for 99.dots and we can install the app and use the same login which you are using for the web version. Is it possible for follow-up reminder message to STS and patient? So currently there is a system for SMS which is being sent to the patient as well as the RNTCP staff. So in the daytime, if the patient doesn't take a pill, so he is given a reminder message at 1 PM. So after that, if the patient doesn't take the medicine, the RNTCP staff, wherein the STS, is given a message at 3 PM so that he can call the patient and follow up. If the patient is out of district of ART center and client registered in my ART center, we doesn't provide any medicine of TB. So what are the solution of this to save the life of the patient? So if the patient is taking ART center in the specific ART center, he would be provided anti-TB medication in that ART center itself, so that the patient can avail both the TB and HIV services in the same ART center, wherein this is called the single window delivery mechanism. So how can we do manual entry? So currently patient registration is restricted to the ART center. So the patient goes to the ART center, he gets diagnosed as TB and he started on medication. So the ART center staff, they start the 99.dots entry and transfer the patient to the RNTCP team. So the technical support phone number for 99.dots software issues, it would be shared via email to all the ART centers. So regarding difamputon tablet is not available, the concerned RNTCP cell will be contacted and informed. Regarding link ART center access for 99.dots, we would consider the same and get back. So 99.dots can be tracked by private practitioners, wherein we would have to include the private practitioners as a dot provider. So we can register the patient, private practitioner as a dot provider, wherein he would also get an SMS alert. So regarding revised monitoring and evaluation tools, haven't reached a specific ART center, this would be addressed. So DAPCO can access the data for review meeting, you would also consider the same and We can consider a different login for a DAPCO setup also. How to register outcome of regimen change. So we have considered the feedback and we would address this also. So I think we are done with the questions here now. So we have more questions here. So 99 dots does not have rifabutin. How do we manage the patients? So when the patients on second line ART are shifted to rifabutin based regimen, so they would be tracked via other methods of adherence, which would not include 99 dots. So either the health worker would visit the patient and track adherence, or the family member will track the adherence. One patient is staying on platform, no phone, him what to do? So this has already been addressed. Sometimes the patient can't give any mobile number. So majority of the patients do have mobile number. In case they don't have a mobile number with them, we can take the mobile number of the family member. Whoever is residing with the patient, their number can also be entered. What to do for daily dots from ART Center, Chandrapur? So we can pass over the feedback to a specific RNTCP center. Transfer out patient figure is not shown in the overview window. So once we transfer out the patient from a specific district to another district, the patient would be shown in that district where he is transferred out, and he will not be shown in the patient where he was transferred out from. How to change login and password? So login and password are fixed and they can't be changed. So we need death cases in separately. So whoever patients have been given an outcome, they can be accessed under past patients. Few patients are taking pills in the evening and giving free call, but on same day supervisors will get the message in the afternoon that they are missed doses. Yes, this is under consideration. The messages which are being sent to the RNTCP staff are sent at 3 p.m. so that if the patient is not taken the medicine, the STS can remind the patient. Ideally, for under RNTCP, the guidelines prescribe that the patient should be given drugs in the taken drugs in the morning. That is either 2 hours after taking breakfast or half an hour before medication. So when will you get revised HIV TB registered? So we would pass on the information to the RNTCP team and the SACs, respective SACs. How to upload treatment card of patients in 99 dots? So in 99 dots, we are registering the patients and entering all the details, and we don't have to upload treatment card. Basically, we are entering the treatment card in 99 dots. I think we are done with the questions here now. If there are any specific more questions, you can write in and we will get back to you via email.
Thank you, Dr. Deepak and Ms. Reena, for such an informative session on 99 dots. Thanks to all the participants for patient listening. All the participants are requested to kindly post in their questions. The unanswered questions will be shared along with the recorded link with all. All the participants are requested to also kindly enter the e-poll, which is going to display on the screen. Thanks to all again.